There's often quite a bit of confusion in Salesforce around roles and how they differ from profiles. So let's get that sorted out. Profiles are for controlling access to people who need all similar abilities and features. All sales reps have to have the same sales rep profile. All support people have the same support profile. It's a way of giving access to big clumps of people all at the same time. Roles, however, are totally new ways of giving access in Salesforce based on hierarchy. So let's imagine that your company has a very hierarchical structure. The CEO is at the top, and underneath them is a range of executives. They each run a department which has teams and managers and regional managers, all the way down to maybe the entry-level graduate who reports to their boss, who then reports to their boss, who reports right back up the chain, eventually all the way to the CEO. If this is the case, then you'd expect a sales manager, for example, to be able to see all the leads and opportunities and accounts of all the sales reps that sit underneath them. The head of Europe should be able to see all the information in Salesforce about their European customers. The head of New Zealand should be able to see all the information in Salesforce about New Zealand. It sounds simple enough, right? Unfortunately, if we were just relying on profiles, then this would actually be really difficult to set up. There's a lot of interplaying people here, and the security would just be really messy. Enter in roles. Roles are our way of sharing data in Salesforce based on a company's hierarchy. The idea here is that everyone can see their own data and all the data of those beneath them in the hierarchy. So the CEO, if you were to take a guess, they can see everything, but the graduate at the very bottom can only see their own stuff, no one else's. This sort of sharing is actually enabled by default in Salesforce for all standard objects. You can turn it off if you like in your org-wide defaults, or you can turn it on for custom objects there as well. Maybe you only apply role hierarchy sharing to certain objects in Salesforce. Who knows? The choice is really up to you. To create a new role in Salesforce, you just go to Roles in the Setup menu and click on Add New. If you've never set them up before, you may need to click on Setup Roles first and then follow the onboarding session. You give the role a name, like Regional Manager, and then assign it to users using the Assign Users to Role button. The big question with roles is really always, do I need them? To be honest, if you don't need to share data using a hierarchical structure, then the answer is no. You don't need roles. They are not compulsory, just another tool that we can use to share data in Salesforce.